understanding how those cells function, how they interact, how the entire body works together was really always very impressive to me. Now being able to use high-end technology in my profession and applying this to a good use, to finding a treatment for Parkinson's disease, is really satisfying. Basically, I reached a point where I always wanted to be. My name is Anne Grünewald, I'm a neuroscientist, and I started my own team here at the LSSB thanks to an FNR ATTRACT grant. I'm interested in Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is a movement disorder that is caused by the loss of a particular type of nerve cells that is required to regulate or control our movements. Genetic forms where a certain mutation in a gene is inherited in a family. However, the absolute majority of patients is affected by so-called sporadic Parkinson's disease. That means we still don't really know what causes this disease, and we have only very limited options of treating. This is a model of a nerve cell. And this is relevant because we're dealing with Parkinson's disease, which is caused by the loss of nerve cells, the dopaminergic neurons. And what we can see here is, for one, the nucleus in the very center. And then around it, you can see a lot of other compartments of the cell. And in my research, we are very much interested in the mitochondria, which are here nicely shown in red. And those are called the powerhouse of the cell, because this is where the cell basically uses the energy from nutrition and transforms it into a kind of an energy currency. And our hypothesis is that there needs to be very tight regulation between these two compartments, and that this communication is disturbed, which then leads to the mitochondria not being quite as efficient and functional as they would be under normal circumstances. Address our research question we are interested in, we're using two different model systems. One of them is post-mortem tissue. That means that there are patients who during their lifetime agree to donate their brains for research after they deceased. Using those sections, we can actually do a single cell analysis in those samples. We're using a technique called immunofluorescence labeling here, and using this technique we are able to target proteins inside of the mitochondria, which give us an information about the function of those. We are comparing here on the left side a control with a patient here on the right side. The difference in intensity gives us an indication that the function is indeed disturbed. The brain sections we are working with obviously only allow us to look at the status quo of the protein profile at the very moment when the patient passed away. So the second model that we're using is a cellular model, which is in a dish. Start off with skin cells from patients, allow the cells to be reprogrammed into a stem cell-like state, which is a state where the cell is kind of yet again diverse in its options. And from this stem cell-like state, with a very, very difficult culturing protocol, you can then redirect the cells to eventually follow neuronal fate and turn into the dopaminergic neuron type that we are primarily interested in. Once those models are very well characterized, we can then use those to ideally test the effect of potential treatments for Parkinson's disease in those cell cultures. you're better. No, you're better. Cool, again. Okay. Yeah. This still looks really amazing. We like it so much, we put an image in our office. So, yeah, still quite fascinating to look at such a neuronal population, and that we're able to create this in the lab is great. In the future, I would hope that we can use personalized medicine, so treatment that is specific to certain subtypes of the disease, specifically addressing the disease there where the problem in the cell occurs. Thanks to the ATTRACT funding, I was able to set up my team here at the LCSB, which is a rather interdisciplinary institution. There are two more groups which are primarily working on the very same stem cell models. We have a constant exchange, shared meetings, basically run into each other in the corridor. Being embedded in this kind of setup just seemed to be the perfect fit for my research.